The thought of having a semi-auto 338, it's nuts if you think about it.
What's up, everybody? Welcome, Squad Squad, and welcome to Slav Guns at the Range. We're here at Media Day 2022, and obviously, I'm having a lot of fun because we started at the right side. We started with some machine guns, and now we're talking about the big 338s. We're looking at suppressors. And I'm here at the booth for one of the companies I've been following for quite a long time for making some really awesome looking guns. And then this just takes it up a notch. So if you want to shoot a precise, accurate gun, you can obviously get a bolt gun. And you can get one in 338 Lapua. But what if you can get a 338 Lapua in an AR platform, including all the modularity? And this is it. I'm here with Matt, who's going to tell us all about it. So Matt, sure. Thank you for having me.
Thank you and for stopping by. I appreciate it.
Let's roll.
Yeah. So this is our Kivaari. It's a 338 Lapua. Quick takedown. The barrel comes off. You can run this in a backpack and a hard case. All of our guns at DRD Tactical are quick takedown. So our ARs, standard ARs, we run in 5.56 or 300 blackout. We've got an MFP pistol. We're running on that side over there. We've got a CDR-15, which is basically a standard AR platform. And then we have our Aptus, which is an internal guide rod system, so you can run the stock folded or not. We jump up to our Paratus, which is a 308 or 7.62 or 6.5 Creedmoor. And then we have our M7.62, same calibers, just in a standard AR-10 platform side. And then we jump up to the Kivaari here. Yeah. So I think we're going to run this thing in a second, right?
So I've known DRD for the Paratus. It was like such a beautiful looking gun. It's been out for a little bit. It's just a gorgeous looking gun. It's like if you want to have something nice, you want something that's accurate and shoot, that's good. But this just like, it's the next step up. I mean, like, what would possess you to do a semi-auto 338?
I mean, there's a lot of dangerous critters out there, so we need to make sure that we can take care of that. If you got a Chevy Suburban just kind of running amok on an airplane field or something like that, this was going to take care of that job for you. So that's kind of what we were thinking. We just like big calibers.
So, you have 223. Some of them can be finicky, especially if you go to other calibers. Yep. I mean, it seems like if you're going to go something like a 338 or a 300 mm mag, I mean, it would take quite a bit to make sure it runs right. Or, I mean, sure. Like, how finicky or how do you deal with that?
Yep. So we have our own gas block, and it's a 5-position. So you've got 100%, 75, 50%, 25, and closed or open all the way. So that allows you to make those adjustments quickly on the fly. If you're going to suppress this gun, they are definitely finicky because depending on ammunition, temperatures, I mean, there's a lot of things that can do that. So just standard without a suppressor, they're pretty good. Once you dial them, they run all right. If you put a suppressor on them, you've got to make those adjustments, which with that 5-position block is really easy to do. So that's why we developed that.
And so I noticed there's a big ass latch on the side of the gun there. I guess that's a quick change system or how does it work?
So these just basically you're popping this pin. That pulls out right there. This comes off, and then you just put your barrel wrench on, unscrew this nut, and you can pull that barrel right off and put it in a backpack.
Okay.
So super discreet, easy to use. Sub MOA when you put it back together. We do recommend that you wrench tighten them when you're gonna run them. If you were in a situation where you needed one shot right away, you could hand tighten it and do it. But really, for repeatability and everything, you just wrench tighten them.
Okay. And I guess basically, because I'm assuming it uses a extension, so there's not going to be head spacing issues when you put it back or anything else like
it's
that.
It's got a barrel extension on there, so once it goes up, it locks up. On the top of your upper extension or your upper receiver, there's a slot, and that alignment pin just goes right in there, and everything is squared away.
Okay. So it's in 338 Lapua. Are there any plans for any other calibers that are using the same bolt face?
Yeah, we've looked at a couple different ones. Right now, we're really planning just this gun is going to be 338. We have a couple new ones coming out. Okay. If you stop by the booth this week, you might see some different stuff.
Exciting. I'm getting all tingly. So before we get, what's the price point and availability?
Between $600 and $6,500, depending on color. Generally about 60 days on lead time on these right now. There are some distributors that do have them in stock. If you're a dealer and you're looking to get one in, you can check a couple of the distributors out and they have them, or you can always contact DRD directly. And we can set you up as a dealer. End users can go run our website and order them.
All right. So if you have a choice between getting an NDM 86 or something, some stupid overpriced Russian AK, and it hurts me to say that right now, This is just so much better. And if you're considering a Mac 10, those are even more expensive than this now. And this puts bigger holes in place.
Longer distance.
So Matt, thank you for showing this to us.
Thank you guys for stopping by for sure.
And we're gonna send some lead down range. And as always, thank you guys for watching. Keep on squatting and I'll see you in the next video, linked up here.